Hello and welcome to my guide about Pokemon Unite Fundamentals. Fundamentals are essential skills of a given game, which don't change despite meta changes, etc. They are things which always stay true and relevant. If you have strong fundamentals, you are able to climb up the ranks all the time, even if you haven't played the game in a long time or have no mechanical skills whatsoever. I will go over what fundamentals are and what aren't, so that you get a good understanding on what you should be trying to improve on and what might be just time waste or only temporarily fixes to your gameplay. The fundamentals are trading, minimap awareness, camera control, input accuracy, input speed, damage foresight, spacing and efficiency. Those are the things you should work on and try to improve the most. Other things are not as relevant as those. Things you shouldn't worry too much about, but people usually do, even though it's not necessary, are meta, roaming, gangs, weird item build orders, cheeses, and strategies. Basically knowing what Pokemon is the best and using the best items on it and using cheeky strategies might give you some wins and short-term success. However, once the meta changes or evolves and the cheese strategies are not viable anymore, you are suddenly clueless and all knowledge is useless now. If you are good at the fundamentals, it does not matter what Pokemon is currently the best or what is meta, you will always be able to adapt to it and have success on the long run, even if in the beginning you might not have had as much success as a temp elo player. Everything you work for will stay true and skills can't vanish with one patch and your efforts will never be wasted. Obviously knowing what is meta and playing that is never a bad thing and will help out, but it's not the thing you should be worried about or what you should be focusing on in your training. Now I will go a little bit over the vocabulary and explain what those things mean so you get a better understanding of them. Trading, meaning knowing when you should use spells on enemy Pokemon and when you shouldn't. Minimap awareness, being able to look on the map while playing and using that information to get a good grasp on what's going on in the game. Input accuracy and input speed. Damage foresight, being able to know how a trade fight would look like and being able to form decisions based on that. Spacing, knowing at any given time where you should place your character. Efficiency, reducing the amount of downtime and using the uptime optimally. I hope this video was enjoyable for you and you maybe even learned something from it. Well, good luck on improving and we'll see you in the next video. Bye.